This conference will now be recorded.
Hi friends, good morning. So in this Business Intelligence Master Program, so in today's session we are going to understand what is integration runtime. Okay, what are the different types of integration runtimes we have? So basically we are going to see the introduction to integration runtime. We will deep dive into integration runtime basically. Okay, let's see. In today's session we are going to understand what is integration runtime and what are the different types of integration runtimes we have, and what is Azure IR. Okay, what is Azure Integration Runtime? You remember whatever we have used to copy data from blob to blob, one folder to another folder, whatever we have done, so all those things we have done with the help of Azure IR. What is Azure IR? What is self-hosted IR? Okay, when to use these things? What is SSIS IR? So these are the three different types of IRs we have: Azure IR, self-hosted IR, SSIS IR. So we'll talk about each one in detail, when we need to use Azure IR, when we need to use self-hosted IR, when we need to use SSIS IR. Okay, then we will talk about which integration runtime should I use. Basically, apart from these three, you have a something called that I will tell you. There is a one more integration runtime called auto resolve integration runtime. That auto resolve integration runtime will be a part of the Azure IR, but there is a specialty for that particular auto resolve integration runtime. I will tell you what is the specialty of that particular Azure IR. So basically it will detect the location based on the location that particular IR will be launched. Example, I have a person in US and he need to do some work, like he need to ship something from India to Australia. It is very difficult for him to have or to shift some data from India to Australia when he is in US. But if he is in Australia, it will be easy for him. Okay, so I know my address, so I can able to receive the product. Whatever product is coming from India to Australia, if I am in Australia, it will be easy for me to receive the product. Let's say tomorrow, product is going from India to US. Then you must be there in the US. You should not be there in the Australia. Meaning, so based on your destination where we are copying this data, we need to have a compute infrastructure. We need to have this computational power. We need to have this particular machines. We need to have these computers in our destination location. You understood? We need to have this particular thing in our destination location instead of having at a fixed place, right? So likewise, integration runtime detect the location. Okay, user is trying to copy data from where to where. What is the destination? So whatever destination you are trying to copy, in that particular destination, computer will be launched. Computer will be launched if you use a auto resolve integration runtime. If you use normal Azure integration runtime, you are going to say, okay, my computational power should be there in your US. Doesn't matter from where to where you are copying, whether you are copying data from India to Singapore, India to Australia, India to UK, doesn't matter. Your computational power always will be there in the US only. That will not give better performance. That's why we have something called auto resolve integration runtime. So it can identify your target location. Okay, user is trying to copy data from India to US, then I must be there in the US. It will be launched in US. Your user is trying to copy data from India to Singapore, so our computational infrastructure will be launched in Singapore. It will identify basically what is your destination location. Okay, you need to understand that. Okay, that is what auto resolve integration runtime means. We will see, we will talk about that, and determining which IR to use, how you will identify which IR to use is basically we will talk. So when we want to move data from cloud to cloud, you are going to use Azure IR. When you want to move data from on-premise to cloud, you need to use self-hosted IR. If you want to execute any SSIS packages, then you are going to use a SSIS IR. But we will discuss in detail all of those things. Okay. Overview diagram. I'll just quickly show you overview diagram, which will give you better knowledge. Once we go through all these points, if you go through the overview diagram, you'll have a better clarity on when to use what IR, okay, what each IR can do. Let's start with what is integration runtime. Anybody have gone through the documentation? Anybody understood what is integration runtime, friends? Anybody understood what is integration runtime? Anybody know what is integration runtime?
It is basically the compute that is required to execute the pipeline, right?
Correct. Many people will have a confusion, right? What is this compute all? Okay. Example, you are chatting in WhatsApp. How these messages will deliver to the end user? How these messages will deliver to the end user? Anybody know this process? You will type hello. This hello will be converted into zeros and ones. Try to understand first. This hello will be converted into zeros and ones. These zeros and ones will travel through the wires. Okay, will travel through signals. Will travel through signals. Understood. So then at a destination location, again, what we are going to do, we are going to convert these zeros and ones to the text. How you will convert these zeros and ones? Anybody know ASCII, American Standard Code for Information Interchange? What it indicates, there you have a, okay, for capital A, it's a 65. So for small a, it's a 97, something like that. For one, for number one, it is a 45, something like that. They have defined some values. So how you can convert these particular letters into numbers, they have given some ASCII values. That's why we are able to transfer the data. Previously, we have only ASCII. That's why we were able to chat only in English. But nowadays, we can able to chat it in our local languages. How it is possible? Because we have a Unicode now. Unicode defined for local languages, not only for capital A, not only for small a. It can be Hindi, it can be Telugu, it can be Tamil, it can be Kannada. For everything, they have defined some values. For native languages, they have defined some values. That's why nowadays we are able to chat it in our local languages. Okay, understood. So basically, all this particular movement, data movement, everything is going to be done with the help of zeros and ones. So now, who is going to do, how this conversion is going to happen, how this movement is going to happen? We need some computational power. Why we need to supply continuous power to our laptop? Because our laptop continuously going to progress. It is going to convert these letters to this text to the numbers to the text. Continuously it is going to do. So we have some hardware and software. Computer is nothing but hardware and software. Hardware will have actual data. Software, what it will do, it can read this data and it can do all the transformation. Let's say you may delete some data, you may add some data, all this data, when you save it, it has to save it in a hard disk. Again, when you are trying to read, it needs to fetch it from the hard disk. Softwares will do all these things. Okay, so example, you can use a Notepad++, you can use anything for reading the data, but actual data will be there in a disk. Okay. Now this entire process is happening within a computer. Computer is a computational infrastructure. Understood? So if I have my computer, this computer is with me. So who is going to manage this particular computer infrastructure? I am managing. I am managing my computer. I am supplying power to my computer. I am providing internet to my computer. Isn't it? So I am installing required softwares in my computer. Everything I am doing. So this computer is nothing but my infrastructure. So as I have this infrastructure, I am able to deliver this session today with all of you, right? Next thing. So I am maintaining this infrastructure. You need to understand this infrastructure is maintained by me. Okay, I am maintaining this infrastructure. Okay. So if you have this much knowledge, you can able to understand what is integration runtime. See, now you understood. So how your WhatsApp messages, everything is delivering in the same way. I want to deliver some data from one storage to the another storage. One location to the another location, we needed some computational power, right? So that computational power we are going to provide with the help of an integration runtime. So depends on where is your data. Your data may be there in a cloud. Your data may be there in a client location. Okay. Example, some of my data I have stored in a cloud. Some of my data is there in my local system. So why I have stored some of the data in my local system, some of the data in a data center? So the reason is the whatever data I have, the data is basically sensitive information that is basically related to my business. I don't want to expose this particular data to outside world. So that's why I'm storing all this data in my computer. Whatever data which is a public, okay, public and able to see, that data I'm loading into my cloud. Now you need to understand, whatever data you have in your cloud, that you can able to access it by using a separate infrastructure. whatever data I have in my computer, if you want to access, you need to have a proper permissions. For that, you need to do some extra installations. You need to register with your cloud keys and extra stuff you need to do. We will talk about all those things, but try to understand this infrastructure. We have a three different types of computational infrastructure which is available in Azure Data Factory. That is, I will talk about those things when I was discussing about integration runtime types. Okay, let's see what is integration runtime. You see, integration runtime, that is nothing but IR. If somebody asks you what is IR, don't confuse what is IR. Malai has not covered. It is nothing but a integration runtime. Okay, integration runtime is nothing but IR. IR is the compute infrastructure used by Azure Data Factory. We discussed. We have a delivery boy who will do the things. Delivery manager will manage in the same way. Azure Data Factory is kind of a manager who will use infrastructure like IR. IR is infrastructure. Azure Data Factory is going to use this IR to do the data integration capabilities, to connect to the different sources, to connect to the different destinations, to move data from one place to the another place, to do the transformations, to dispatch the job. Meaning, suppose I want to assign job to some other processing engine. So all these things will be done with the help of this IR. Okay, so data integration capabilities, it can able to integrate, it can able to connect with the different resources across different network environments. Different network environment means if IR wants to connect to my computer, it can connect. If IR wants to connect to the cloud services, it can connect. That's what I was telling you, right? So some of the IRs can connect to my computers because my computer is having some sensitive information. All the IRs I will not allow. First thing. Next thing is to access the data which is there in a cloud, we have a other integration runtimes. Okay. Now you need to understand this integration runtime is used inside Azure Data Factory. The IR job is to connect to the different sources and the destinations, maybe to move the data, to transform the data, whatever it has to do, it is going to do. Okay. And this particular data movement is going to be done between the different network environments, different network environments. So whatever data I have, that is a private network. It's a my private network. Cloud is a public network. So anybody can able to access that data if you have a proper permission. But if whatever data I have, that data I don't want to expose to anybody. Say example, Microsoft Teams, they can able to see whatever data I have stored in their data center. But whatever data I have in my local system, nobody can able to see this data. Okay, so that is nothing but whatever data I have in my computer. It's a private network. This data is available in private network. Whatever data I have in cloud, that is a public network data. Okay, so IR can connect to the different sources and destinations which are there in a different network environments. Next. An integration runtime specifies what kind of hardware is used to execute activities. Okay, what kind of, so integration runtime specifies what kind of hardware is used to execute activities. Okay, where the hardware is physically located, where this particular hardware is physically located, whether it is located in a client location, example, it is located at my organization or in the cloud. So we need to decide where hardware is physically located, who owns and maintains the hardware, who is going to maintain this hardware, whether I am going to maintain or cloud is going to maintain, and which data stores and services the hardware can connect to. This particular hardware can connect to what all data sources. So that is what this integration runtime specifies. So depends on the integration runtime that you are using, you will come to know this integration runtime is where it is located, who is managing, okay, what all services it can connect to. Okay, try to understand. So if you're not able to understand from this point, try to understand what I'm explaining. IR specifies. So let's say if you're selecting a one type of IR, it will talk about, it can connect only to the cloud. It can connect to the only cloud resources, cloud storages, cloud databases, and whatever IR you are using, which is used only in the cloud, right? That is managed by Microsoft. That particular infrastructure will be there in a data center. Okay. But if you look at other types of integration runtime which I'm going to use. That is, let's say you have something called self-hosted integration runtime. This self-hosted integration runtime is located in my location. In my location, it can able to connect to my network and the cloud. It can connect to the private network plus cloud. So if you want to move data from my computer to the cloud, then what you need to use is, you need to use something like self-hosted integration runtime. So integration runtime specifies, depends on the type of integration runtime you are using. You will come to know where this integration runtime is located, who is maintaining, okay, what all sources it can connect to. Please try to understand 3 points. Okay, so where this integration runtime is available depends on integration runtime. First point that you need to understand, where this integration runtime is located. Second point, who is going to manage? Third point, what all resources, what all storages, what all databases it can connect to? These 3 points we need to understand. So how you will understand is, you specify which integration runtime to use in each linked service. So in linked service, if you remember, I was using integration runtime, right? So you need to specify, when you are connecting to the storages, databases, you need to specify what integration runtime you need to use. What integration runtime I want to use, that particular integration runtime I need to use inside a linked service. See, under linked service, we have an integration runtime tab. If you go to integration runtime tab, you will have a default integration runtime, that is auto resolve integration runtime, that you no need to create. By default, it will be available. Now let's go back. Let's see here. So where to use this particular integration runtime? See, connect via integration runtime. At this particular place, you are going to use this particular integration runtime. This IR you are going to use at this particular place. At this particular place, you are going to use this IR. Clear to all of you? This particular IR you are going to use at this particular line. Next. Integration runtime actions, right? So now, one second. Okay. So integration runtime activities, what it will do? See, data flow. So we have a something called transformations. To execute those transformations, your integration runtime can submit your job. Example, you have a job. That job you want to execute on the Spark cluster. Integration runtime can take this job and it will submit on the Spark. So for that, you can use the integration runtime, okay? Data movement. If you want to copy data from one network to another network, let's say from my computer to the cloud, maybe within a cloud, block to block, or I want to move data again from block to my computer. So in all these data movements, you can use the integration runtime. Activity dispatch, exactly whatever I told, right? So activity dispatch means you can able to submit this job to the some others engines. Example, Spark engine. I want to give Spark engine to execute this particular job. So activity dispatch. Dispatch means sending. So this particular job, you can send it to the some others engines. But if you want to execute transformation, that also you can able to execute. So integration runtime, you can use to move data. You can submit the job to some other process, or your integration runtime itself can execute these jobs. Finally, we have SSIS package execution. If you want to execute any SSIS package execution, that also you can do it with the help of integration runtime. It's nothing but a computer. Okay, you try to understand, it is nothing but a computer. Now, different types of integration runtimes you have. Data Factory offers 3 types of integration runtime, and you should choose the type that best serves the data integration capabilities and network environment needs you are looking for. These are the 3 types: Azure, self-hosted, and Azure SSIS. Try to understand, these are the 3 different types of IR. I will tell you when to use what type of IR. First, I will give the required explanation, then we will move on. Okay. First, Azure IR. Azure IR indicates this IR is located in a data center. In which data center it will be available? That you can able to decide, I want to have this particular Azure integration runtime in US, you can select it. I want in UK, you can select it. I want in India, you can select it. So you can select where you want to launch this Azure integration runtime. But as I mentioned earlier, we have something called auto-resolve integration runtime. What auto-resolve integration runtime will do? So it is a fixed Azure IR. If you create and if you say US, always that computer infrastructure hosted in a US only. But auto-resolve integration runtime means compute will be decided dynamically based on where you are copying data. If you are copying data from India to UK, in UK infrastructure will be launched. If you are copying data from India to Australia, in Australia, infrastructure will be launched. Okay. Azure IR will be there. Please note down somewhere. Azure IR will be there in a Azure data center. Second point, you are like Microsoft is going to manage Azure integration runtime. Second point. Third point, Azure IR you are going to use when you want to copy data from cloud to cloud. So this is very, very important. You need to remember all these points. I'm repeating all these points again and again. So please note down. Azure IR is hosted in a data center. It is located in a data center, Azure data center. Second point is Azure IR is managed by Microsoft. Third point is Azure IR you are going to use whenever you want to copy data within a cloud. Within a cloud means for blob to blob, blob to data lake storage gen one, blob to data lake storage gen two. Okay, for all these things, you need to use Azure. Suppose if you want to copy data from a blob to my computer, that is not possible with Azure IR. That is not possible with Azure IR because cloud is a public. My computer is a private network. So public to private or private to public cannot be done with Azure IR. We need to go to the second one called self-hosted IR. Okay, I'm going to the self-hosted IR. Before I go to the self-hosted IR, please note down Azure. What is Azure IR and where this is hosted? Okay, who is going to manage, when to use this IR? I hope everybody is clear on this. Now let's move on to the self-hosted IR. Self-hosted IR is managed by client. We are going to manage self-hosted IR. Self-hosted IR is located in our own place. We are going to install self-hosted IR in our computer. So our computer is the infrastructure. Because self-hosted IR is nothing but my computer. I will act as a self-hosted IR. So my computer is going to do all the things that I need to do. Self-hosted IR is located at a client location. Client is going to manage self-hosted IR. Third one, you can use self-hosted IR for everything. To move data within a cloud to cloud, from my computer to my computer, from my computer to cloud, cloud to my computer, for everything you can use self-hosted. But when you have a self-hosted can able to do everything, why you are using Azure IR again? Why do you need Azure IR again to move data within cloud to cloud? Because Azure IR is managed by Microsoft. So why I need to take all the headache? So that's why when I want to move data from cloud to cloud, I will use the Azure IR. Self-hosted IR, I'm going to use only when I want to move data from on-premise to the cloud, cloud to the on-premise. Okay. Finally, we have a Azure SSIS IR. This Azure SSIS IR is also managed by basically this you can decide whether you want to maintain or Microsoft want to maintain, but mostly we will leave it to the Microsoft. Okay, and this based on whether you are maintaining, you need to host it. If you leave it to Microsoft, Microsoft is going to manage. But when to use this Azure SSIS IR is if you want to execute any SSIS packages from Azure Data Factory, then you need to use Azure SSIS. Okay, if you want to execute any SSIS packages from ADF, then you need to use Azure SSIS IR. Okay, any questions, friends? Any questions in this particular slide? This is very important slide.
Hello.
Tell me. Yes, sir. Tell me. Arun.
Yes, sir. Yeah, SSIS full form.
SQL Server Integration Service.
SQL Server Integration Cell. Okay. Thanks, Pule. Thanks.
Self-hosted. Once explain. Self-hosted.
Okay. What is hosting? Hosting means we are keeping something. Okay. Hosting means, let's say, flag hosting. So he is launching something. Okay. He is starting something, right? So self-hosted, client himself has to host this infrastructure. Self-hosted, client himself has to host this infrastructure. Azure team is going to host this particular infrastructure. Azure IR means Azure team is going to host this infrastructure. Self-hosted means client himself or herself has to host this infrastructure. So self-hosted is hosted by client, managed by client, and we are going to use self-hosted IR when we want to move data from our computer to cloud or cloud to our computer. But self-hosted also you can use to move data from your computer to your computer and cloud to cloud. For everything you can use self-hosted IR, but we won't use self-hosted IR when we want to move data from cloud to cloud. So if you want to move data from cloud to cloud, we are going to use a Azure IR. Clear?
It's okay, clear.
Malaya, and you are telling like if self-hosted, client self only can maintain everything. That means that what they are going to maintain?
So see, infrastructure is nothing but a computational power. That computational power is nothing but a computers. Okay, we need a computer to copy data from one place to the another place. Okay. If Azure IR, if you select Azure IR, these computers will be created in a data center. Okay, so this will be created in a data center. In which data center you want to create this particular IR, you can select. Okay, you can see all those things where you want to host. Okay, self-hosted IR means I have a computer. My computer I want to use to copy data from my computer to the cloud. I want to use my computer. Okay. Then what you need to do, self-hosted, there is something or some software will be there. That software you need to install in your computer so that your computer is going to be a self-hosted IR. Your computer will become a self-hosted IR. Your computer can able to do anything. Kiran? Clear?
If we are maintaining everything in our computer, why we are going to the cloud?
Yes, that's what I'm saying. Suppose if you have something that can be done, like if you have a something that is doing your job, whatever headache you have, that entire headache it is removing, then why you need to take that entire headache? You can leave to them. Okay, example, let's say if I am going to manage, example, I need to teach a session today, session to all of you. So what is the problem with session is I need to have a continuous power supply. Example, from today morning itself, we don't have power. But it is difficult for us to manage. Okay, so without power, can I able to teach the class? No. So who is going to take care of the power supply? I need to take care. So if I don't have a proper internet bandwidth, okay, what will happen? So I will not be able to deliver the class properly. Audio will break or screen share will not happen properly, isn't it? So all these are infrastructure related things. So these all infrastructure related things, instead of maintaining by me, if I can leave it to the Microsoft, it will be very like I can able to focus on a class, what I can able to deliver, what is the efficient way to deliver the class, what are the new things that I need to add, okay, what are the examples I need to add to these people so that they can able to understand. So I can focus on the actual business instead of focusing on power supply, internet, cooling system, security. So instead of focusing on all these things, I can more focus on my business. That's how you can use a Azure IR, which is maintained by Microsoft. Microsoft is going to do all the things for you. Okay, that's why you need to go and use the Azure IR wherever you can able to use. But where there are some situations where Azure IR cannot connect to our computer because it's our private network. We won't allow Azure IR. some public computers to connect to our network, right? So in that case, we need to say my computer is going to do all the job. I won't do somebody else's computer. I will ask my computer to do everything. In that case, you need to make your computer as a IR. You need to make your computer as a integration one time. Okay, clear?
Well, these all are the algorithms, correct? They have designed from Microsoft side.
What, because?
No, actually, you said like we have Azure IR, self-hosted IR, Azure SSIS. These are all the algorithms which has been developed by Microsoft, correct?
Not the algorithms. These are different types of IRs.
Okay, Malia. Okay.
Malia?
Auto-resolved IR, is it part of the Azure IR or it can be part of...
Yes, Azure IR. That's what I told. It's a Azure IR. So that's why... See, if it is self-hosted, we need to maintain. As it is a Azure type, that's why it is automatically detecting the region and it is launching in a different regions automatically daily.
Okay.
You understood. Suppose if you are going to maintain, how we will maintain in different locations? It is not possible. As it is Azure team, okay, as it has Azure capability, it can able to launch in a different data centers. We have different data centers in different locations based on where we are copying data. Example, you are copying data from US to India. In India, we have a three data centers, Central India, South India, I think some North India. There are three different data centers we have in India. Now, what happens if you are copying data from US to Chennai? Then your computer infrastructure will be launched in a South India data center, because out of these three data centers also, South India data center is the nearest to Chennai. So that's why your infrastructure will be launched in a South India. Okay. Nearest location it will consider.
So if there are two pipelines, Malia, and one has to copy data to Chennai and one has to copy data to Australia, so two times the computer will be launched to copy the data, right?
Yes. So are you going to see, that is also depends on you. So example, you are saying from US, you are copying data from India and Australia, right? So yes. Whether you are going to execute these two pipelines immediately or how you are going to execute. If you have a different schedules, then auto-resolve integration runtime, this infrastructure will be launched automatically in two different times. So when you are copying data to India, in India, infrastructure will be launched. When you are copying data to Australia, in Australia, this infrastructure will be launched.
Okay. And Azure SSIS also is a managed, right? It will be managed by Azure only. I mean, the cloud.
Yes. Okay. So, but if you want to make it self-hosted, that is also possible in Azure SSIS.
Can we execute a package also using the self-hosted, or we have to use Azure SSIS?
Azure SSIS you need to use for executing any package.
Okay. And are we going to see example in the future to execute SSIS package also using this runtime?
But I have some challenges with installing the SSDT, all those things. So if I can able to install, I will explain. Okay.
Okay. Okay.
Malaya?
Yeah, tell me.
Yeah, packages. What do you mean by packages? Can you explain on that?
Package is nothing but you have a stored procedures. Okay, group of stored procedures to make it what? See, SSIS package is nothing but exactly how we have developed our pipelines, right? In the same way, we have some set flow. That setup flow exactly like a pipeline, we have a different activities we are going to use, and these activities we are going to execute as a package. Here we will call it as a pipeline, there we will call it as a package. Okay.
And amongst the three IRs you have mentioned, which is the most preferred and most used IR? Azure self-hosted, Azure SSIS, which is the most used and preferred?
See, depends on your requirement, you need to select. It's not a preferred or highest used. Depends on your requirement for this particular IRs. Okay.
Malaya, in client project, if suppose there are some files are there in Unix servers, so if we need to load to the cloud, so then we have to use a self-hosted ILI. Right?
Yes. So I'm just reading Srikanth's question from the chat one second. So yeah, Srikanth, whatever you asked, so once we published, can we able to see these packages? So you have seen already all these pipelines are available in your area of UI itself. If you want to see entire code, if you want to see all these activities, you can able to see all those code which is generated in backend, all the like activities used in pipeline, everything you can able to see it from the area of UI itself. Okay, you don't have anything else to see all these things. Okay, from area of UI itself, you can able to see all those things. Yeah, you can ask other questions. Somebody is asking.
Yeah, I was asking like in client projects, if there are some on-prem files in Unix servers, if we want to load to the Azure data storage, right? So then we have to go for self-hosted IAM.
Correct. So if you have any on-premise systems to connect to the on-premise system, we need to install the self-hosted IAM.
Okay.
Okay, example, let's say you have computer, your own computer. Okay, in your computer, you have C drive, D drive, right? So from C drive, D drive also, if you want to load files into cloud, you can use the self-hosted. We have SQL Server installed in your computer. So from SQL Server, you want to load data into your cloud, then you need to use the self-hosted. So your computer, it's a private network. So from your computer, if you want to move anything into the cloud, you need to use a self-hosted. But within a cloud example, we have seen moving data from block to block. In that case, you need to go for the Azure IR.
Malaya, how is the performance differences between these three IRs?
See, performance will come in a different category. See, there is, you should not compare the performance between these three. The use case of these three is different. Performance, to improve performance, we have something called integration units. Okay, you need to increase the power of your compute, or you need to increase the more threads you need to open. So multi-threading, right? So you have more threads, more parallelism units you can able to give. So meaning multiple threads are going to start parallelly, your data reading, data loading, everything will happen. So those performance improvements you need to do. It's not related to your IR. With the help of IR, if you cannot do like performance improvement, you need to change the some settings to get the performance. So you cannot compare the performance between these three. The use case of these three are different.
Okay.
But as I mentioned, so instead of creating your Azure IR, if you go with auto resolve integration, and then you'll get better performance. You can compare between those two, but you should not compare between these three. That's what I told. To get the better performance, we have auto resolve integration runtime, which can launch at destination location. If you're copying data from India to Singapore, in Singapore, infra will be launched. Okay, fine, friends. Let's go to the next thing. Azure integration runtime. You see, Azure integration runtime use infrastructure and hardware managed by Microsoft. This point we covered. They take care of the installation, maintenance, patching, scaling, while you pay for the time you use it. They are going to take care of all the installations that is required. They are going to take care of all the maintenance. They are going to take care of the any security patch.
Malaya, your screen is not moving.
Is it? Oh, sorry. Yes. You can see now. Are you able to see now?
Yes, Malaya.
Okay. See, the Azure integration runtime I'm talking. Azure integration runtime use infrastructure and hardware managed by Microsoft. So we talked about this. They take care of installation, maintenance, patching, scaling while you pay for the time you use it. So for whatever you have used, so if you use for 1 hour, you need to make for the pay, you need to make a payment for 1 hour. But all the required installation, maintenance, any security patching, okay, any security related or installations is required, those patchings. Any scaling. So scaling is basically tells you if you want to increase the compute infrastructure, automatically Azure integration runtime, inside Azure integration runtime, it will be increased. Okay. While you pay for the time you use it. So based on how much time you have used, you need to make the payment. Next, an Azure integration runtime can only access data stores and services in public networks. See, Azure integration runtime can able to access only the storages and databases which are available in your public network, meaning in the cloud. Clear? Okay, friends. Okay, next you see.
I didn't understand one point. You said that access the data storage and services in the public network and public network, you said.
Yes.
But how it will we go to cloud?
Cloud is a public network. Cloud is a public network. Whoever is access to the cloud, they can able to see. Example, so all Microsoft team, they can able to access the cloud. Without your permission, they can able to access it. That's why that is a public network. Without your permission, Microsoft team can able to access your data. But my data, they cannot access whatever data I have in my computer. Understood? That's why that is a public network. Okay.
Malia, actually, I have one question, Malia.
Subbu, clear?
I'm clear.
Okay. Vikesh, tell me.
Actually, in my project, they are all using like a networks on networks. They are not using the cloud. Okay. Here you are saying that we need to do every month patching. So it is waste of time. So once we moving to that to cloud. May know you are saying that we need to pay to Microsoft. May know how much they are paying the amount to Microsoft for doing PM patching like that. Do you have any idea?
It's not for installation separate cost, maintenance separate cost, patching separate cost. Everything they will take care in back end. Okay, you just have to make the payment for your Azure integration runtime. Okay, how much you are going to pay, those details we can able to see from the pricing calculator they have given for each resource per hour, how much they are going to charge, those details we have in website. So whoever is interested to understand not only for the Azure integration runtime, whoever want to understand anything, you can just go to Azure pricing calculator and just click on pricing calculator. Okay. So here you can able to search for your integration capabilities, all those things. See, Azure Data Factory, just click on this. Data Factory, Data Pipelines, Azure Integration Runtimes. Okay, so execution based on, see, if you have a integration runtime, okay, data integration unit hours. So based on these units, they are going to cost it. So because inside Azure integration runtime, you'll have units. Okay, based on how many units you are using, they are going to make the payment. You see, if I increase more units, the cost is increasing. If you use 10 units, so that's what I told, right? So performance, somebody asked how you will improve the performance. It's not based on the IR, it's based on the data integration units, and you have a parallel units, parallel threads, number of process, parallel process you can able to start at a time. Multiple threads, you can start, all these threads will work parallelly to read the data and to load the data. So based on these IRs, this particular integration units, you are going to make the payment in your IR. Okay, so you just make a payment to units. So all the installation, patchings, everything they will do. They will not charge you for installation, separate charge, maintenance, separate charge, like that. It will not be like that, okay?
Okay, okay.
See, now your Azure Data Factory will always have at least one Azure Data Integration runtime called Auto Resolve Integration Runtime. This is what I was talking about. If you use Auto Resolve Integration Runtime, you'll have a better performance. This is the default integration runtime, and the region is set to auto resolve. See, the region is set to auto resolve. Automatically, it will resolve the region where this particular IR should be launched, where in which data center this particular IR should be launched. That is automatically resolved. Auto resolve means automatically it will resolve that particular thing. So that's how we will get the better performance. Auto resolve means that Azure Data Factory data set, the physical location of where to execute activities based on the source, sync, or activity type. Based on from where to where you are moving, what kind of activity you are using, so it will decide in which location it has to keep this particular IR. If you need to ensure that data does not leave a specific region for a legal reason, you can create a new Azure integration runtime in a specific region. Example, okay, let's say you have some example. That example is, let's imagine this is this may not match with the actual thing, but for easy understanding I'm telling. Let's say in Pakistan we don't have any data center. Let's imagine we don't have any data centers in Pakistan. Okay, so let's go in a different way. We have a data centers in Pakistan, but we don't have any data centers in India. Okay, try to understand first. We don't have any data centers in India, but we have a data centers in Pakistan. Now what happens is, when you create a auto resolve integration runtime, when you are copying data from US to India, data is going to travel over Pakistan. So data will go to Pakistan, from Pakistan data will come to the India. The reason is, our integration runtime is launched in Pakistan. Why it is launched in Pakistan, why not in India? Because in India we don't have any data center. That's why our data center is available in Pakistan. That is the reason why the nearest data center for India is Pakistan data center. So in Pakistan what happens, we have a data center. So auto resolve integration runtime, when you create, what it will do, it is launched in Pakistan because that is the nearest to India. Now when you are moving data from US to India, that data has to travel over Pakistan, but that is not a that I don't want. I, even though it is taking more time, but I don't want to travel my data over Pakistan. Okay, in that case what you will do, you may select your compute infrastructure in US itself. Okay, you want to create a you want to launch your compute infrastructure in US itself. Understood. In those cases, you need to create a your own integration runtime instead of going with the auto resolve integration runtime. In that case, you need to go with the Azure integration runtime instead of going with the auto resolve integration runtime. If you go with auto resolve integration runtime, what is happening? IR is launched in Pakistan and my data is traveling over Pakistan, that I don't want, even though processing is taking more time due to some regulations. Okay, so due to some legal reasons, what I wanted to, even if it is taking more time, I don't want to travel data over Pakistan. I want to travel my data over, or like directly it should come from the US to India. Okay, in those cases you need to say my Azure integration runtime should be there in the US. You can specify instead of using auto resolve. Okay, so any questions on this?
Amalia, Arun. You are saying you have to, the data should be transferred from US to India, no? So if you are creating in the US itself, like how the data will get transferred from India, if we don't create we don't allow to travel over Pakistan, that's what I'm asking. Within US itself, you are creating both the
can able to deliver the your data. Okay, you need a computer which can deliver the data, but if you have a computer in US, it is very difficult to travel because it has to send the data long distance, right? So but if
yes,
you have
sir.
If you have a compute in Pakistan, that is the nearest to you, it will be easy for the computer to read the data and load it into your destination location. Okay, so it will be easy for a compute to receive your data quickly. But the problem is, if you don't have data centers in India, so you are launching your data centers in Pakistan. So but if you launch if you launch your IR in Pakistan, data will travel over Pakistan and reach India. So
okay.
We have security risk. That's why we don't want this, even if it is taking more time to move data from US to India. I want to launch my computing infrastructure in US.
Okay, okay. So it will take some more time than the normal one. Okay, okay.
Sir, I have one doubt, sir. Can we see the auto resolve integration region? Which one it has taken?
Auto resolve integration and the
region. Which region it will automatically?
It will take the nearest to your destination. That's what I was telling from the beginning of class. When you are moving data from US to India, India is your destination, your target. So then nearest to India, whatever data center you have, in the data center computer infrastructure will be launched. It is not decided. So based on your activity, based on your source and sync, it will decide where to create this auto resolve integration on time. Desire where to launch, that will be decided at the runtime. When you run a pipeline, it will decide, okay, so he is trying to copy data from India to Singapore. So in Singapore, it will launch the infrastructure.
Okay.
Malaya, is there any way to see where it is launched when the pipeline runs? I mean, in the
I think we can able to see. Yes, we can able to see.
Okay.
We'll see those things. I did not check whether we will be able to see or not, but I think we can able to see. We will see. Okay, when we execute any pipeline, right, it will give our idea. Okay, we'll see those things in our monitor tab.
Okay, sure.
Next, self-hosted integration. Use self-hosted integration runtime, use infrastructure and hardware managed by you. So client, we need to manage. So you take care of all the installation, maintenance, patching, scaling. So we are going to do this installation, maintenance, patching. So I will tell you how you can install all those things. But you also pay for the time, use it through Azure Data Factory. So its computer infrastructure is yours, but you are using your computer infrastructure with Azure Data Factory. Azure Data Factory is managing this. So that's why Data Factory is managing these things, for that management, you need to make the payment to Microsoft. Self-hosted integration runtime can access the resources in both public and private network. That's what I told. You can move data from your computer to cloud, cloud to your computer, cloud to cloud, from your computer to your computer. Anything you can able to do with self-hosted IR. Self-hosted integration runtime works like a gateway. You install the integration runtime on a machine inside the private network. Then it can communicate with the Azure Data Factory. Okay. So I have my computer. This is in my network. So I can install the self-hosted IR in my computer. Then I will register with Azure Data Factory key, so that my IR can communicate with the Azure Data Factory. All those things we'll see practically. Okay, do not worry. Try to understand the things. If it is not clear, do not worry, because everything I will show you practically. Installation, everything. How the self-hosted IR is communicating with the Data Factory, everything we will learn. Okay. Next, SSIS integration on time. Azure SSIS integration on time. So clusters of virtual machines running the SQL Server integration service engine managed by Microsoft. So here SSIS, so as of now we were talking about a self-hosted IR, Azure IR, right? Those are only single missions, but if you want to maintain high availability, that is also possible. But here SSIS IR means group of missions will have group of computers. Instead of working with a single person, we have multiple people who are going to work for executing this SSIS packages. They take care of all the installation, maintenance, patching, scaling, while you pay for the time you use it. So who is going to manage SSIS IR? So SSIS IR is managed by Microsoft basically, but mostly that's what I told at the beginning also. Mostly we will go with Microsoft to manage the things, but we also can manage these things. Okay. Azure SSIS integration runtime used for executing SSIS packages in Azure Data Factory. Okay, from Azure Data Factory, if you want to execute any SSIS packages, you can able to execute. Those SSIS packages can access resources in both public and private network. Okay, so maybe SSIS package you have created, which is accessing data from on-premise or from cloud. So whatever it do, but those kind of SSIS packages you can able to execute from the Azure Data Factory by using SSIS integration runtime. Okay. Next, SSIS integration runtime. You see, so node number, you can mention how many compute you want when you are creating SSIS integration. You can mention the number of computers you need, what is the computer size, in which location you want, all those things you can specify when you are creating SSIS integration runtime. Which integration runtime should I use? How you will decide? You see, Azure integration runtime, self-hosted integration runtime, SSIS integration runtime. Azure integration runtime, you are going to use copy data between cloud stores, transform data between cloud stores using data flows, execute activities using cloud store and services. So if you want to do anything in the cloud, you need to use the Azure integration runtime, self-hosted integration runtime, copy data between cloud and on-premise stores, copy data between on-premise stores, on-premise to on-premise, execute activities using on-premise store and the services. Okay, if you want to do anything in on-premise, you need to go with self-hosted integration runtime. Execute SSIS packages through Azure Data Factory, then we need to go for Azure SSIS integration runtime. Okay. Which integration runtime should I use? See, for Azure, self-hosted, Azure SSIS, public network. So within a public network, if you want to execute data flows, data flows means the data transformations, if you want to do data movement, just I want to copy the data, activity dispatch, I want to submit my job to some other process, maybe for my Spark engine, I will submit this job. Spark engine is going to execute this job. So activity dispatch, for all those things, you can use the Azure IR. Self-hosted IR, you can use for same, within a public network, private networks. In both the cases, you can use the self-hosted IR. Self-hosted IR, we are not going to use for the data flow execution. Transformations within a data factory, if you want to execute, in that case, self-hosted IR will not work. Azure SSIS, SSIS package execution may be within a public or private network. In both the cases, you can use the Azure SSIS. So you try to understand all these things, but if you have any confusion, do not worry. Try to remember few things, okay? When we see practically, we'll have a more clarity. Integration.
Malaya.
What?
Malaya, Arun, doubt.
Tell me, Arun.
Virtual machines, in one slide you said, now I may know what is virtual machine actually, just to have a quick understanding.
Yes, sir, Srikant. So we need to use a self-hosted IR. That's what I do, right? Inside SSIS IR, we are going to use a self-hosted IR to access on-premise. Okay.
Yeah, that virtual machines means, I just want to know, I have understanding, like virtual machines, yeah, means it will be a, like, real computers, yeah, or like...
You have a computer, right?
Mm.
You can able to touch it, you can able to see it, you can able to interact with your computer, isn't it?
Yes. Work, yes, computer, yes.
Same kind of your computer will be there in a data center. That
okay,
you
okay,
your computer. That is virtually available, but you cannot touch it, you cannot see it physically.
Okay, okay. I'm not, okay, I cannot feel physically. Okay, okay. It will be in somewhere else. Okay, fine. Okay. Okay, okay.
IR location can be different from the location of the data factory it belongs to. If you choose to use Azure IR in public network, which is the default? Okay. See, example, you see, if you are using a auto resolve Azure IR in public network, this is the default one. You see what will happen for copy activity. ADF will make the best effort to automatically detect your sync data store location. Then use the IR in either the same region if available or the closest one in the same geography. If the sync data store region is not detectable, IR in data factory region as alternative is used. So what it means? So example, you are trying to copy data from India to Australia. Okay, what is your sync region?
Australia.
Very good, Australia. But ADF is not able to identify what is your sync, where you are trying to copy the data. Okay, so maybe due to different reasons, it is not able to identify what is your location, destination location. Okay, in that case, you are, even though you are using AutoResolve IR, it will be launched in a same region where you have created Azure Data Factory. If you remember, when we have created Azure Data Factory, we have selected region, create in East US, create in South India, like that. So if ADF can able to identify from where to where you are copying data, so it will be launched, it will launch your AutoResolve integration random. That is nothing but a, your infrastructure will be launched at the Australia. Okay, that is your destination location. If it is not able to identify, then your IR will be launched in the same location where you have created Azure Data Factory. Okay, that is the meaning of this. Okay, clear? For example, you have your factory created in East West. Data factory created in East West. When copying data to Azure Blob in West US, I'm copying data to Azure Blob, which is there in the West US. If ADF successfully detected that blob is in West US, okay, if ADF detected that your blob is there in West US, copy activity is executed on IR in West US. Okay, where IR will be there? In a West US. If the region detection fail, okay, if ADF is failed to understand this blob is available in West US, copy activity is executed on IR in a East US. What is East US? This East US is a location where you have created your data factory. Okay, data factory located in East US, you are trying to copy data to West US. If ADF found that you are trying to copy to West US, then IR will be taken from the West US data center. If the region detection failed, if it is not able to identify your copying data to West US, then your IR will be taken in a same location where you have created factory. Factory created in East US, so IR will be taken from the East US. When copy data to Salesforce of which the region is not detectable. Okay, when you're copying data to the Salesforce, you don't know where you are copying this data. Okay, copy activity is executed on IR in East US. Okay, so in these kind of situations, IR will be taken in East US. Why East US? Because East, in that location, you have created your data factory. If you have created data factory in South India, then IR will be taken from the South India. Okay, determining which IR to use. Copying between two cloud data source. What you will use? Can you tell me? Copying between two cloud data sources. What type of IR you will use?
Azure IR.
Very good. So we are going to use a Azure integration. Copying between a cloud data store and a data store in a data source in a private network. What IR you will use?
Self-hosted.
Copying between two data source in a private network.
Self-hosted.
External transformation activity. So I want to dispatch my job. I want to submit my job. Which IR you will use?
Azure IR.
Azure integration. Okay, data flow activity I want to execute. Azure integration. Okay, you need to remember these points. Okay, next. Overview diagram. You can see this overview diagram will give you more idea. So this is a on-premise. See, this dotted line below everything is on premise. This is a cloud. Okay, this is a cloud. Again, this is a virtual network within a cloud. Okay, within a cloud. Now you see, from on premise to cloud, if I want to connect to this source to destination, see, self-hosted you are using, to connect to source to destination, maybe you are copying data from cloud to cloud to on-premise or on-premise to cloud. If you want to move from this to this, you are going to use a self-hosted IR. Okay, again, you see, this is everything is that their source and destination both in the cloud. You are using what? Azure integration on that. You are executing SSIS packages within a cloud. You are using Azure SSIS. Okay, next thing that you need to understand, you are moving data within a virtual network. In the cloud, you have virtual network. What is virtual network? I will tell you. If you create a virtual VM, I have created a virtual machine inside cloud that will become a separate network. This is also become a cloud. This will become a again on-premise. You remember this particular part again becomes the on-premise. Okay. So if you want to move data between this particular virtual network to virtual network, that is nothing but on-premise to on-premise, on-premise to on-premise, again you need to use a self-hosted IR. In the same way, if you want to execute your SSIS packages which are connecting to both cloud and on-premise, you are going to use a Azure SSIS IR. Internally, it is going to use a self-hosted IR. That I will show you. Okay. So this diagram, if you can able to understand, you will have a more clarity. That's all slides I have. But any questions, please let me.
Malaya, if the SSIS package is there on our on-premise system and it has to move the data to the cloud, so in that case as well, we use Azure SSIS.
Azure SSIS you can use, but internally it is going to use the self-hosted IR.
So we should have our self-hosted as well configured, right? Then in that case,
so. Yes, yes. So when you are creating, I think I don't have anything. I don't have any data factory. Let me check if I have any data factory. Let me show you quickly. Let's quickly add it. Let me explain you. We'll have more. Let me just give you some 5-10 minutes lab so that you will have clarity on this. Like okay. East to west. In which region I am? Harish, please be in here. Name cloud cloud panit area of V2. This name maybe somebody has typed, I can say cloud panit one area of V2. This name must be there. Git configuration, I'll configure later. Click save, replace date. Click me. Click go to resource. Click author and monitor. Come to manage tab, click on integration runtime. You see default integration runtime, auto resolve integration. Let's click new. Okay, self-hosted or Azure, if you want, you just select this, click continue. So what you want, let's go with Azure. Self-hosted means you need to install. See, use this for running activities in on-premise or private network. Just use Azure. Okay, see, when you use Azure, there are two options, auto resolve you want or any location you want to select. You can just use whether you want any location, specific location, in specific location you want to launch or you want to say auto resolve. Auto resolve already available, so if you want specific region, you can select this. Okay, cancel it. Now let's click new again. Let's select Azure SSIS, click continue. So east west node size, so compute if you want 2 or 4, you can just keep increasing. Okay, then click continue. When you click continue, you just select, you don't have all these things actually. You should have all these things to go to the next step. Basically, we open all these things. If you have any database available, we can able to give all these things. Let's say, see, this is the drop down, I cannot take it. Let's give something. Let's try to give something. Will it enable now? But what happens once you give this database name, username, and password, it will ask you to go to the next. You are going to enable continue. Once you continue to the third tab, there you can able to see. Let me just quickly show you those tabs. So I think here. Okay, so first thing is clear. See, this is the second screenshot. In third screenshot here, deployment settings. You should have a few more options. Okay, anyhow, I will show you later how you can create this SSIS package. So at third step, see, this is the kind of a page you'll get. Here you'll have a three different options. You want to use a self-hosted IR, what you want to use. Go back. Node size, all these things, nothing, right? So you just have to go with to continue. Here you need to select your catalog database, all these things. Once you select, if you provide the username and password, you will continue to launch the page. When you continue to the next page, you will have a like you can select the what type of IR you want to use internally.
So basically, before creating this Azure SSIS, we should make point it to that SSIS DB which we have, right?
Yes,
so
yes.
That is what it is. Okay.
Yes, you are right. Yes. Okay. We'll see those things later. Okay. Thank you. Thank you. That's it.